Miss Winterbourne, hold it right there.
Hi, Wyatt. Hi, Piper.
Never mind that. I just wanted you to know that Wyatt will not be in your class tomorrow, or ever again, for that matter.
Why? Is there a problem?
A problem? You mean like when Wyatt was playing with that little girl at the Play-Doh table this morning?
You mean Emily? She's such a sweet little psychic.
She stole his dough right out of his hands, and you did absolutely nothing.
Well, stole's a little harsh, don't you think? She's only 2 years old.
No, that's not the point. What message is this sending to him? That people can just take from him? That people can hurt him? That grown adults will not be there to protect him?
Piper.
What?
We need to talk. Would you mind taking Wyatt for a stroll just for a minute, please?
What?
It's all right, go ahead.
I'll be right over there. Come on, let's go.
Are you out of your mind?
Piper, do you realize you're driving everybody nuts around here?
Well, I don't really care, because see, I'm trying to protect our son.
From who? His mommy and me, teacher?
Hey, how do you not know that she's the one who's after him? If Phoebe's right...
She's not.
How do you know?
Because why would anybody we know want to turn Wyatt evil? It just doesn't make any sense, just like Gideon said.
How do you know it's not him? Or us, for that matter?
Piper.
No, I'm serious. What if he saw what this life did to us and how hard it was and just decided to take the easy way out?
It's not what happened.
How do you know?
Because Wyatt is surrounded by love. We love him whether we're together or not. He's got a brother that risked everything just to save his life. Plus, he's got two aunts who would rather gouge out their own eyes than see anything bad happen to him.
Just promise me we'll keep him safe.
I promise.